NFS is a file sharing protocol developed around the same time as SMB and is often used as its alternative. With the addition of the ROS package, both protocols are now supported in RouterOS. We already configured SMB before, so now we will have a closer look at NFS. This protocol generally goes best with Mac and Linux. Theoretically, you could use NFS with Windows, but not the way you might be hoping for. The typical advice you can find online is to go to the settings window where you can add support for NFS, because then it will become possible to use the built-in command prompt mount command with NFS. But unfortunately, this feature is a little outdated. It does not support NFS version 4, and in RouterOS we do not support anything below version 4. So if you are adamant about using NFS with Windows, you'll need to do that either through some third-party tool or maybe WSL. This video is not about that. We will first cover the RouterOS side, and then we will have a look at interoperability with Linux. If you are on macOS, that part will suit you too, because the syntax is identical to Linux, or at least very close if not identical. The NFS protocol should theoretically outperform SMB in speed, but it is more lacking in security. If SMB is something that you have to be cautious with, then with NFS you really have to be careful about where you use it and who has access. Before we get into the configuration, I want you to understand three biggest security pitfalls. First of all, there is no encryption by default. Data is transferred in plain text, so anyone who can capture your traffic could also read your data and even try to tamper with it. Theoretically, there is an option to use Kerberos with NFS 4, but currently we have not implemented that in RouterOS, and I doubt it would be worth going that route anyway. Another security consideration is that the capabilities to read, write, and execute files rely mainly on Linux file permissions. This implies that anyone with root privileges on their system can not only change who else can work with those files, but they could also create special permission files that always get executed as a specific user, for example, the root. This can open doors to privilege escalation in some systems. RouterOS is not affected by this because users are not allowed to execute files at all, at least not on the router. So this is not so much an issue with exchanging files between a couple of routers, but rather when you're adding other devices into the mix. And that leads us to the third consideration. The authentication is host-based. The connections to the server are accepted or dropped purely based on IP addresses. In RouterOS, that means that anyone who can reach the router will be able to mount any shared directories. You simply have to control access with firewall rules. Alright, with security matters out of the way, let's move on with the configuration. Setting up NFS sharing between two RouterOS devices is very easy. Go to the disk section in the terminal and locate the storage location that you would like to share. For me, that is an NVMe drive, but for you, it could be something else like a USB drive or a TMPFS folder. To start NFS sharing, use the set command with the NFS sharing property equal to yes. Then, on the other device, in the disk section again, type add type NFS, followed by NFS address, and give it a name. The network location should show up, with the total and free size visible. To test it, I could now create a file from the client side. I have to specify the full location within the name field. If I then check the server, I can see that the file is indeed on my NVMe drive. Now let's see what happens when I mount this share on Linux. It mounts without any problems, and my file is there. If we have a quick look at our permissions, we can see that this file is owned by the root, and any user is allowed to read and write. So I could rename it, and since I am at it, I could also change the permissions a little. In RouterOS, you cannot see file permissions, but the file got changed. While this file is completely harmless to our router, you could see that if I was a malicious user, then I could trick another user running this file, and it might not go well for them. So let's remove it and consider a slightly more secure option. The NFS implementation in routerize might still change in the future, but the server-side setup is very simplified. If you're looking to have complete control over NFS, then you should set up the server side on Linux and mount it on routerize. I will try not to go too deep into Linux configuration, as you could do many variations, but I want to give you a quick look at one way to do it. First, create a new directory at your preferred location. The default file permissions will do, but we have to change the ownership to nobody. Next, edit the etc exports file. In a new line, type the location of your folder, followed either by an entire network that you want to share files with, or a specific IP address. Then in brackets, add options. Besides read, write, and sync, there are several other things you could specify. For example, when a client writes a file through NFS, the default behavior of the server will be to overwrite the user ID and group ID to nobody in Linux file permissions. So if you prefer, you could change that in these options. But I want to keep this behavior, so I can save this file and run the export fsarv command. Finally, I can start the server and mount the location on my router. Now, I could try to create an evil file from a connected client just like before, but the difference here is that when I go back to my server and look at the newly created file, it belongs to the nobody user who cannot make changes to any existing files or programs on my computer. I could still harm myself by running it with sudo, but overall this is a little bit more secure. The only downside is that now I can't add files as my main user with the current folder permissions. Of course, I can still create files in this folder as root, and they will be visible to the clients. But if a client tries to edit the file, then the changes will simply not get saved. If I want clients to have full access to this file, I would have to change the ownership. It is an extra step working from the server. If I need the server to regularly write files to this location, I would probably just mount its own NFS, but you can find other creative solutions. Thank you for watching, and let us know in the comments if you use NFS in your setups. Is this a valuable feature or something that you'll be staying away from?